Indisputable exclusive. A man is accused of stealing his own bike. He did not steal a thing. Here it is.
This is my bike.
Let me see your ID.
Come on, homie.
Let me see your ID.
Hey. Yeah. I got the guy. He's got the mongoose bike sitting right here. He's coming off the bike path.
Hold on.
I got the cops with me now too. I just seen them as well.
I'm gonna give you my ID.
Yeah, put the bike down.
I'm over here by the Hocking.
Yeah, I have the lock and all that for you.
Yeah, the lock and all that for it?
Yes, I bought it.
That don't mean I got a lock too.
This is mine.
Hey, chill out, chill out.
I know. The cops dealing with the rest of that, man.
You go to college here?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Yes, I have to go on the website.
Copy. That's gonna be the individual on the bike.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes, I'm his grandmother.
Mm-hmm.
He purchased that bike.
Yeah, bro, I ain't got nothing against you. My bike sounds like it's stolen out of the yard. You're coming from the same exact way that
did he order it on his own account?
You were up here at the top of the hill with the
bike.
Yeah. Okay.
All he has to do is just go on you and pull it up.
Okay. If he can pull it up, then I will look at it. Okay.
Started to leave. So yeah, it made it look a little suspicious, homeboy.
Hey, go over there, Deontae. Did you order this on your phone?
I know.
This bike? Can you show me the receipt, like on your purchasing?
It made it look a little suspicious, homeboy, is what the man said. Not, you know, I'm sorry. I made a mistake. There's more.
And the thing I bought with it is the bike lock.
That's the bike.
Yep.
All right, man. You're good to go. That's all that we needed, because somebody with the same description bike just stole it.
Yeah.
Do nothing to him.
No, he's good to go. He just showed us the purchase order.
So who is this?
Does that purchase order matches that on the side of there?
Yes, it does.
Who is this person accusing him of something he didn't do?
My name is Kyle, ma'am.
You are wrong.
There's no need to talk.
So
go over here.
I am sorry, sir. I apologize for that. Like I said, my son's bike was stolen. You were just coming in the same direction. I do apologize, man. There's nothing against you. I just want to make sure I get my son's bike back, all right, man?
You see, many protocols were dismissed by the authorities because a white man said a young black man did it. Now, typically, if you claim somebody stole property, the first question is, did you file a police report? In that police report, it will have what's called identifying information, such as a serial number, something that makes it really concrete that this is the item. I heard none of that questioning during this debacle. Let's put up the picture full mass of the victim who endured this. I'm gonna give you the background. 19-year-old student of Hocking College who was stopped on his way home from work at the campus cafeteria of Nelsonville, Ohio. Here is former Hocking College freshman Deontae Ford with his two grandmothers. Look at that. They love him. A culinary student, Ford was headed home from his job in the college cafeteria. He said he believed the stop was racially motivated. He told Indisputable, and I quote, "In some ways, it was a good thing. I learned from it to always have proof and identification." You know, it's a sad reality, young brother. The proof is you are in possession of the item. That proves that you have either A, faculty of operation, or B, ownership. That's how the court looks at it, okay? Anything else is a violation of your rights and a violation of protocol. Investigative prowess, we call it. The grandmother, Cassandra Aaron, showed Indisputable the bills for his semester at college. So he's paying $7,000 according to that bill. That bill, he's paying money to be oppressed at that campus. That is insane. Ford withdrew from this program on September 9th, the day after his police encounter. For his grandmother said their family, they weren't going back to risk him staying in that area. She said they initially thought he would be on the diverse side of the campus, and there is a diverse side of the campus according to the narrative. But she said his dorm was more than 20 minutes away by bicycle. "We don't feel safe," she told Indisputable, "with him driving around on his bike at night. The day we had to move him, that day we saw Confederate flags in the rural area he was staying in. It was the kind of place my mom and dad would say, don't you dare go there." Once again, sad reality, because you have a constitutional right to travel wherever you choose. Let's put it up. All right, incidentally, a band of Confederate soldiers looted and burned Nelsonville, Ohio in 1863. They are obviously proud of this heritage. Ahrens said she wrote a letter to the president of Hocking College, which was not returned. She told Indisputable, "Only a bill from the school. That's it. Paid his money." College's financial aid website says refunds are not issued after the first day of class. Here's the president of Hocking. Yep. Betty Young is her name. Now, President Young, you have a decision to make here. A simple statement at this point would do. The student has withdrawn from the program. You may want to consider refunding the money, at least prorate it. Now, I'm a professor myself. I understand some of the nuances of collegiate activity and campus culture as it relates to the police. Protocols were violated. At least show that you are a student advocate, if you are able. Sharon, thoughts here?
I'm guessing she's not able, okay? Yeah. The refund should be available for racial profiling, because that's what we saw. And I want to thank you for clearing it up with this young man who's been indoctrinated to believe that he has to, like, really, ex-slaves, freed slaves, had to carry their papers in this country. It's not a lesson that he should have to carry around proof that it's his bicycle. That's sure. Not a lesson that he needs to learn.
Right. And I want, thank you for saying that. And I want to say this to the brother, because I know he's going to see this. We understand. All right, we understand. So here's what I would like you to do. There's a different overview. Sometimes there are things that happen where we are to learn a lesson. But there are other times when we are to give the education. And dear brother, I would like for you to consider that what happened to you puts you in the position of educator. All right?